Ladies and gentlemen, dear Mr. Herman Van Rompuy, President of the Administrative Council of the College of Europe, dear Mrs. Federica Mogherini, Rector of the College of Europe, dear Mr. Alexander De Croo, Prime Minister of Belgium, very welcome, Mr. Prime Minister, dear Mr. De Caluwe, Governor of the Province of West Flanders, dear students of the Ilian Vogel-Polsky promotion, and dear professors. As the mayor of Bruges, I am very pleased to welcome you to our beautiful city. I have already met some of you during our traditional student welcome at the beginning of the academic year. And now we are gathered again for the official opening ceremony. We are proud to have you as our guests. And we are also very proud of the presence of the College of Europe in Bruges. Since 1949, the College has been a symbol of union and cooperation between different countries. It attracts young Europeans with a thirst for knowledge and shapes them into critical citizens. Together, we can make Bruges a more European and even more international city. Because it's thanks to the presence of different nationalities that Bruges became great during the Middle Ages. Bruges embraces diversity. This has been the case for centuries. During the Middle Ages, Bruges flourished as a trading center. The 15th century truly was Bruges' golden age. It attracted people from all over the world. The Dukes of Burgundy settled into the city, and Flemish primitives, as Jan van Eyck and Hans Memling, found the creative hotspot they needed in Bruges. However, when the court of Burgundy left Bruges, the international tradesmen also disappeared. Years of war followed, and in the middle of the 19th century, Bruges was a poor city. During that time, George Rodenbach wrote his book, Bruges la Morte. In this book, he describes Bruges as a somewhat sleepy and mysterious place. A year and a half ago, it seemed that the times of Rodenbach were back. The coronavirus hit us suddenly and hard. We had to practice social distancing and stay indoors as much as possible. The usual very busy streets of Bruges became empty. But the book by George Rodenbach had a silver lining. It attracted the curiosity of our very first tourists, because Bruges is a special place. It speaks to your imagination. Last year, we wanted to encourage tourism in our own town, so we launched the Imagine Bruges campaign. We highlighted our assets and also the lesser known but equally charming places in the city. And we also wanted the international tourists to know that we missed them. That feeling is mutual because a few weeks ago, Bruges was voted one of the cities that people missed the most during the lockdown period. Over 800,000 readers of the travel magazine Condé Nast Traveler not only missed Bruges, but they also are planning to come back when things look better. We have difficult times behind, and we are still not out of this pandemic. More than ever, I am convinced that we are in need of strong-minded people who believe in a Europe where cooperation is of great importance. And therefore, dear students, I look in your direction. Because this is why you have taken up studies in the College of Europe. You will learn so much during your studies here, but I also hope that you will make time for leisure. I want to invite you to explore our beautiful town. Visit our many museums and learn about the rich history of this medieval city. We have many things to offer. One of those is Winter Glow, which started on November 26th. 13 light installations will extend across the city. The skating rink and the cozy winter bar will become a winter hotspot, and our Christmas market will be given a completely new look. I highly recommend it. Dear students, in the next few months, you will all become a citizen of Bruges. I sincerely hope you will enjoy your stay in our city and that will forever occupy a space in your heart. Thank you very much.